contrast to the way they've played away from home.
Well, I think it's they appreciate being in front of their own fans.
Here's a chance right away for Hunt. Moving in. Saved by Reimer.
He was a passionate player, a passionate coach, and I think the players, they respond to that. They come out and play hard for him.
Teravainen wheels and fires. Tipped by Aho, but intercepted by Spurgeon. And Stahl wraps it off the boards and out to center ice. Hunnan tried to play it back to Koivu. That did not connect. Nakish able to knock Spurgeon off the puck, and that creates a loose puck at the point. Dubnyk gets beaten from long range. And Edmondson's goal has Carolina in front 1-0.
On a little bit here. Luke Cunning with a little bit of a relaxed play in the half wall, then just an indirect play up. Slapper, Dubnyk had clear eyes on it the whole way, just beat him top shelf. But it looks like maybe it deflected off Cunning's stick.
It's harassing each other a bit after that faceoff. Brodin now with it. His pass off target held by Hamilton. A long shot and a sliding save by Dubnyk. Payne's control in the corner. McGinn sends it around behind the net. The centering pass deflected by Rask, and they score. Aho pounced on a loose puck and flips it up and over the shoulder of Dubnyk.
Carolina's game plan and really the identity of their team unfolding right now. They just shoot the puck from absolutely everywhere. There, a shot from behind the net. A rebound comes out front. And when you know your teammates are shooting it from everywhere, you know that at any point the puck can get there, so you're always working to get to the front of the net. There it happens.
Hamilton to Teravainen. Slavin walks the line. His long shot goes wide. Hamilton, a sharp angle shot that goes off the post. Tip by Parisi. Fortunately, caught a skate of a Carolina player. Ricochets back the other way. Parisi on it again with a shot. Saved by Reimer. Hamilton for Slavin. Hit by Zucker, separated from the puck. Zuccarello throws it around behind the net. Hunt quickly on it there for Minnesota. To Zucker in behind. Zucker for Stahl in the circle. His shot blocked by Niederreiter. Stahl has it back. To Zucker, a shot. Saved by Reimer.
Zuccarello goes down. That's 2 minutes. And now Stahl, after a good offensive zone shift, able to feed Zucker. Pops into a nice soft spot there. Nice little shot, but Reimer has had the answer. A couple of big saves for him.
Brodin holds for Minnesota. Cunning to Eriksson-Ek. Down low, Greenway. Greenway centers. Eriksson-Ek, the shot saved by Reimer. Puck still loose. Reimer trying to find it.
Dumped back to the front of the net where Eriksson-Ek was able to get a rebound. He's doing a lot of those things, and he's really starting to learn his body, and that's really starting to help his game out offensively. Now, as soon as he brings that to the front of the net, which is what Bruce had mentioned he wants to see next, as soon as he learns to play the middle of the ice with that big...
Fiala trying to go in behind for Parisi. Parisi works out front of the backhand, saved by Reimer, and he's able to cover again with traffic in the blue paint.
Easy type of play. He didn't get a second opportunity there. A lot of times on these, he'll get a rebound, a whack, maybe take it to the far post. But these are the plays that we're accustomed to seeing from him.
Rebound finds Greenway. Greenway sends it to the corner. Brodin down low. Back out front. A shot. Cunning scores.
He's had the big shifts. Power forward, he changed the momentum in the Anaheim game down to when they were down two as well. Nice play by Brodin to activate and hit Cunning, who just makes no mistake about it. Quick little one-touch shot, and that's not an easy shot on his offside.
Hurricanes don't have a shot yet here in the second period. Here's a chance for Zucker. Back to Stahl, and a glove save by Reimer.
And down the left wall. Gives Stahl a nice pass, and Reimer able to flash the leather on it. Catches it. I think if Stahl could get one more opportunity on that, he'd try to go a little higher with it. I don't know that Reimer could have caught up with it.
Jordan Stahl jumps around Spurgeon at the Minnesota line. Tied up by Zuccarello. Loose puck, they score. Fogle beats Dubnyk over the glove. And on Carolina's first shot of the second period, they stretch the lead back to 2-3.
Jordan Stahl just gets the puck. Zingle just feeds Fogle, who jumps into a little spot here. It surprises Dubnyk, kind of climbs up. It's not the heaviest shot, just looks like one with eyes, crawls over him a little bit. hits that high corner of the net.
Zuccarello comes to center. Fiala cuts to the middle. Fiala denied by Reimer.
Power play opportunity off the rush there. Zuccarello headmans it to Fiala. I think he tries it. Oh, he didn't try it. Able to just bring it to the forehand. Maybe looking to feed Stahl on the forehand. Sneaks the puck through there. Nice little opportunity on Reimer, who's able to get the blocker on it.
Teravainen looking. Wanted Shvechnikov on the weak side. Hamilton, Teravainen a shot. And a save by Dubnyk. Teravainen gives to Hamilton. Back to Teravainen. Teravainen into the corner. Aho, Teravainen weaves in close. And Dubnyk got a pad on it. Koivu maintains the puck. Back to Dumba. Good at the line. Parisi out front. Same rebound. He scores!
The clears on the kill. Then Koivu and Parisi get a two-on-one. Parisi a little bit too tired there. Looked like to catch up with Koivu. But what a play by Koivu at the offensive blue line. Backhanded pass across the ice to Matt Dumba, who sees Parisi down there, just gets it to him. Parisi does the rest.
McGinn could not clear. Rask knocks it down. Rask fights through a hook from Martinook. Rask still with it. Spins it back to Soucy. He scores!
But Rask, who I think has been playing some good hockey lately against Arizona, he made some nifty plays. He's calm with the puck. Does a little dipsy-do on the sidewall. Picks his head up. Finds Soucy streaking. Soucy just fires a nice little bullet, low blocker, and beats Reimer.
Connect to Zucker. And now it comes across to Zuccarello. Zuccarello to Eriksson Ek. He has Hunt with him. Eriksson Ek in a shot. Oh, it trickled through Reimer. And he was able to sweep it away just before it crossed the line. Beaten Reimer. And the puck just bounces out. And then is swept away by Hamilton at the last second.
Yeah, Reimer able to get that puck. Pushes it across the goal.
Greenway trying to hold him off. Maintains the puck. Fights through a Svechnikov check. Greenway still with it. Cuts to the middle and hit the post. He beat Reimer but hit the post. What an incredible show of strength by Jordan Greenway.
Jordan Greenway, who's been a beast all night, holds off Pesci, then is able to beat Svechnikov and Pesci out of the corner with it. Does a little juke on Eriksson Ek on his way there. Splits him, takes a five hole, and then you see it just squirts off that far post as it goes through the five hole.
And this will be the second. Carson Soucy's first in the NHL is the tying goal. In his overtime plan of attack, we've seen him use two defensemen before, but he'll start with Eriksson Ek as the only forward. Hamilton lays it across. Svechnikov moves in and scores. And the Hurricanes win it in overtime by a final score of 4-3.
They quickly headman the puck up, and Svechnikov picks it up. Just shoots a rolling puck that I think fools Dubnyk a little bit. Talking to goalies at times, those are the toughest to pick up when they get rolling on you. You don't know how it's going to come off the blade.